Hello, welcome to FX Bootcamp. My name is Wayne McDonald, Chief Currency Coach of fxbootcamp.com. Today is Wednesday, June 11th, 2008. This is your daily video technical briefing, a review of what we did during the live New York trading session at fxbootcamp.com. Let me remind you that the purpose of FX Bootcamp and this video is education. It's not an alert service. We don't make any trade recommendations. Also, trading and investing is risky business. However, Forex is unique in the sense that you're leveraged 101 or even more. As an amateur trader, once in a while you'll get lucky and that leverage will work for you. But more often than not, it's going to work against you. Please do not trade real money until you have a track record of success using a demo account. Today's video is going to be reviewing our pound dollar trade. We had some pound strength and dollar weakness today. So, and with the dollar weakness, we're basically shorting the dollar across the board. But let's talk about this one particular trade. This is right as New York was opening. You could see that during the European session, the pound versus the dollar was going up and up and up and up. But for about an hour, it was coming down, 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 down. Well, what do you want to do? Buy low or buy high? Well, in this case, we're looking to buy low with the anticipation that it'll continue making a higher high. So you can see predominantly everything's moving up right here. And over on the one-hour chart, the 5.8, which represents momentum, has been rising since yesterday's low. So even though there's this quick dip back down to 9,500, that big old wick right there shows that there's lots of support. And ever since, price has been rising. So we're actually looking for an opportunity to go long. And the way that I explained this at FX Bootcamp while everything was live was that, swing traders might be looking to go long based on an hourly chart. Spot traders are looking to go long based on a 15-minute chart. And, of course, scalpers want to go long eventually on the 1 minute. So our job here was to wait for our opportunity to go long. Okay. Now, what we used as a trigger was this MACD. Okay, let me open this up on a 1 minute chart. This is a lousy, stinking, no good 1 minute MACD. And the logic here is if you were looking to go long, there's no reason to go long now when MACD is falling. It's falling, it's falling, it's falling, it's falling, and falling. Now, what we're trying to do on the hourly chart here is ride the 5 on the hourly. Well, we're coming back down, and we're at that 5 EMA now, right around 95.80. So if we're trying to ride the 5, then you want to buy near the 5. Okay, so what that does is now that we're there, we might find some support. If we find support, then on a 15-minute chart, you'll see that the 5.8 is pointing down on the 15-minute chart. So that's a little bit challenging. Okay, but if anyone's seen the videos that I've done on how to use the smart plan methodology, when we're down at the 21, when there's good angle and separation between the 21.55, that represents that the market is up and that you actually want to look for opportunities to go back long. And when that usually means the next 5.8 cross to the upside if you're a spot trader. So what I'm doing is I'm using medium, short, and scalp methodologies using the various time frames to try to scalp my way into the spot trade. Now, I could wait for the 5.8 cross on the 15-minute go long because that confirms the 21's in control and the market's up. And then, of course, the 5 EMA on the hourly will be riding that. So everything will look really good. So I want to scalp, and this is what I was doing live at fxbootcamp.com, is teaching people how to scalp into the spot, and then of course the spot's going to turn into a swing, okay, for a pretty good trade. And so the ultimate trigger was, if we want to go long in all time periods, we might as well wait for this MACD, because with my custom settings using fib ratios, MACD is fairly slow, so that will be a nice little trigger to scalp in here, and then the only thing we have to worry about is, will we make a higher high? Will we flip the 5.8 back up? So that's what we did, and let me show you what price looked like going to this 1 minute chart. Okay, at the time, this is what price looked like. Okay, it was coming down, da 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 da, and finally we hit the 200 minute EMA and a 5.8 cross to the upside. So now we have momentum up, and now we just have to wait for the MACD as a confirmation. That's what we actually did, and we waited. We're still waiting. Isn't that interesting? Let me go back to price action so you can see this. I think a lot of people would have went long right here after the touch of the 200 EMA. Let me zoom in. A lot of people would have gone long here, and all of a sudden it comes all the way back, maybe knocking out for a small loss, or maybe you just have your stop right here hoping for the best. Well, in that case, you're holding your breath. What we were doing is just waiting for the MACD. We were thinking long, we just didn't have our confirmation yet. So we waited, and waited some more. In fact, let me get rid of the stochastics. We don't need it in this case. So we're just waiting. We're still waiting. See our buddy MACD? And finally, we get a MACD cross right in there. It's subtle, but that's what we were waiting for. And it was a pretty specific setup. So let's take a look at what price action was doing. Well, if you went long here at that 200 EMA and went long in here, then you might have got in, let's say you got in a little late. You're in here around 90, and then it dropped all the way back to below 80. That might have knocked you out for a loss. Meanwhile, boot campers never got in. It looked appealing here, but we were using a MACD as a trigger, and it kept us out until about 80, 83, I think, is where one of the boot campers was in. And that's our opportunity to go long, right in there, okay? See, it's the MACD cross. In fact, if I use a vertical line here right on the cross, you can see that that's exactly where we went long, okay? Isn't that interesting? So we're in around 95.80. And that, on the 15-minute chart, that means we're right in here, this little touch of the 21, or almost a touch of the 21. And it's a little risky for a spot trader to do this. But remember, we know this going in. Our attempt is to scalp our way into the spot. And the spot happens to agree with the swing trade. Okay, so the 15-minute agrees with the 1 hour. So we're just going to be a little aggressive getting in for the best return. Now, it's a little more aggressive, but it certainly isn't a stupid trade. So let's see what actually happens. Let me zoom in on price, and let's see what happens from here. Up, up, little pullback, up, 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 up. So at this point, you can move your stop to break even, okay? So now your stop is, let's say, around 83. Let's see what happens based on the new swing, the new higher low, okay? And up and up and up and up and up. Okay, you can count that as a pullback. Move your stop. Okay, now your stop is about 89, about 90. Okay, so we're in at 80, so now you got 10 pips locked in. Making some highs here, waiting for a pullback, and then it really spikes here, so move your stop now. So you're in at 80, so now your stop is at 96.05. Okay, so now you got 25 pips locked in. Let's see what happens from here. Little pullback, new continuation, move your stop from 96.05 to 96.20. So now you, you're in at 80.20, so you got 40 pips locked in. Off she goes. Okay, now remember, we're in on the MACD cross. So why not exit on the MACD cross? See it? Nothing emotional at all. Nice and steady, Freddy, moving straight forward. Okay, no emotion, just purely logic, and you're out. See the MACD cross? You're out. So, you know, you're in at 80, and you're out somewhere right in here, around 50. I think the actual exit was 47. So you're in at, let's say, you were in at 83, and technically you're out at 47. Hey, that's not bad. So if you're, let's just call it 70 pips minus a few pips, so 70, let's say 65 and a spread. So you walked away with 60 pip profit there. Nice little scalp trade. You're in on the MACD cross, out on the MACD cross. And that's exactly what we did minute by minute with the during the live class at fxbootcamp.com. Now, we're also looking at the Euro-USD rising. We watched the USD-Swiss franc fall. We watched the USD-Yen fall. I skipped the Aussie-Yen looked great, but I skipped it because of some earlier technical issues. We skipped the pound-Yen because the pound was strong and the Yen was strong. But, you know, we also watched the CAD, and with oil today, it was pretty amazing. But, you know, the yen pairs we're definitely watching. The one we eventually did take was the euro yen, and that was really good because the S&P 500 was falling, the 10-year T-note was rising, and oil was rising. So a lot of things going on. Stock markets around the world, the Nikkei was tanking, the FTSE was tanking. In fact, let me show you. We were watching this tank like crazy. So that helped us in some of these trades. And then we watched oil. We talked about going long at 34, and all of a sudden we found ourselves at 37. Guess what happened when it hit 37? It dropped back to 34. Isn't that amazing? $3 up, $3 down in about a half an hour. Whew, scary stuff. In any case, today is Wednesday, the 11th of June, 2008, and this has been your daily video technical briefing by fxbootcamp.com.